Let's talk a bit about Leos Janáček. He's not a very well-known name in piano repertoire, like Chopin or Liszt. So when did you first heard about him and about his music?
Leos Janáček is not one of the most famous composer, and he's not like the common composer that pianists have in repertoire. And I got in love with Janáček almost 5 years ago when I was talking with my professor in Trinity Lab, and Gabriele Baldocci. We were talking about new repertoire to study, and he suggested me to study the piano sonata of Janáček. And then I got in love the idea and the way he express his music that is not common, is very typical of his style, that is unique. So the first time like I started to work on the sonata, then I decided to deep all the repertoire, piano repertoire of him.
Which characteristics of Leos Janáček made you think, I want him in my repertoire, I want to go through the hard work of studying his pieces?
So the element that characterized the repertoire of Janáček are first of all the lyricism of his music. Janáček is full of lyricism and full of beautiful melodies that is really important to express and to feel in a way to feel a suffer to suffer for the music you are playing. So every kind of sound you really need to deep and to work, because it's not just playing, it's go inside the music of him. Also another important character of the music of Janáček is is full of contrast. So you can go from a place where the melody sounds quite relaxed, and suddenly in the next bar looks like there's a storm. So the contrast of moods is one of the typical elements of his music, and this is one of the things I really love about it. Also, the music of Janáček is strongly inspired by the voice, because we need to think that Janáček was a composer was thinking a lot about the voice. Indeed, he composed a lot of folk songs, and also his piano music reflect this idea. So every time it's really important to express, thinking about the voice, all the melodies of the music we are playing.
You play the sonata 1X1905. What's the meaning of the title and what's the story behind it?
So the story behind the piano sonata is very peculiar, because Janáček was inspired by a real event. Basically, in 1905 in Brno, there was a demonstration because people of Brno wanted to have a university where it was possible to speak in Czech, because we need to think that Brno was part of the Austro-Hungarian Empire. And basically, the empire didn't want to give this opportunity to the city. So there was this demonstration when there was killed a worker, Pavlik. So Janáček, after this event, was so inspired on a sad way that he wanted to write this sonata. Some information says that he decided to drop this score on the river, and there was a student of him that likely got some pages. So basically today we have just two movements of this sonata. The first one is named From the Street, because it's connected with the moment where these people were demonstrating. The second movement is called The Death, because it wants to represent through the sounds the moment of the death of this worker. So these two titles show that it's quite connected with the reality, and we can say that it's a piece of programmatic music, and it's really important to throw the performance to give the picture of this event, also working a lot on sounds and give the impression that we are living the moment the sonata talks about.
Which passages were the most challenging for you to play in the Sonata 1X 1905?
The Piano Sonata of Janáček is composed by a few challenging technical moments, because Janáček, also when writes something that's quite tricky, we need always to express the tricky part from a musical side. It's not just playing, thinking about the technique. For example, if we talk about the first page of the sonata, we can see, for example, the left hand that is an accompaniment of the main melody of the right. And this kind of passage it's quite tricky to play in a melodical way. It's important to control in order to support the melody without to cover the sound of the melody. At the same time, it's important also to think about the phrasing of the left hand. And it's really important in this kind of technical moment also to make understand the change of harmony. So there is a double work of controlling the technical challenge of this passage and at the same time to make understand all the harmonical and musical elements. And another important moment that is quite, I would say, quite challenging is the moment on the second movement of the sonata, where the left hand basically jump from two parts of the piano. And also here we need to express the drama of the music. So thinking the energy that passed from one side to the other side. Or if also we talk about, for example, the violin sonata, we see that there is another challenging moment that we also need to solve on a musical side. Here, for example, this op that performing speaking are not very easy. If we just play as normal octave, we miss completely the musical side. Instead, it's always important in Janáček to focalize first of all on the lyricism and the musical point of view.
Which other pieces by Leos Janáček you explored?
So after discovering the piano sonata, I decided to discover in general the piano repertoire of Janáček. I performed during my concert in the Mist the variation opus 1, and now I'm discovering Overgrove Path. Also, I worked with Nicolas Dupont, a very good violinist, and we played and we are going to record also the main violin pieces such as the violin sonata, Dumka, now all this work I did is going to be finalized in a discography project with a CD is going to be out in October for Da Vinci Classics, which is going to contain the main composition of Janáček. And at the same time, the CD wants to be a kind of history from his young compositional style, which is represented by, for example, the variation Opus 1 to the more advanced style such as the piano sonata and in the Mist. Thank you very much for your interest about this less known composer, and see you on the next video. Mm-hmm.